Welcome to GEPL Capital Talks on Tuesday, a weekly podcast, bringing to you an interesting talk related to finance every week. Stay tuned. Subscribe now and press the bell icon to GEPL Capital's YouTube channel and never miss out on any stock market update and build your knowledge on investment. Hello and hi everyone. And welcome back to our Talks on Tuesday, a weekly podcast. This is our episode number 58. Today we will be talking to you about 5 ways to invest in minor name. And we have with us Mitali Mahajan, an investment advisor, providing advice to investors for their investment as well as on asset allocation. Hi Mitali.
Hi Lakshmi.
Okay, Mitali, today you are going to tell us about 5 ways to invest in minor's name. Is it possible to invest on minor name? If yes, then what are things required?
See, Lakshmi, normally we prefer to invest on our name and make minor as a nominee. But I'll tell you how you can invest in minor's name too. In any investment aspects, we require very simple things for investment. One, KYC of parents, second, birth certificate of minor, and third, bank account of minor.
Okay, Mitali, can you tell us the instruments which are available for investment?
Yes, there are traditional investment options. One is fixed deposit, recurring deposit, second, PPF, third, insurance. In non-traditional options, there are one, direct equity, second, mutual fund, and third, gold.
Okay. And Mitali, can I invest any investment with all these documents?
Yes, definitely. In traditional investment option, can be invested through above documents. Guardians can invest on the behalf of minor in any of the traditional instrument like bank fixed deposit, RD, or PPF account. Second, PPF investment can be done and the tax benefit under Section 80C is clubbed with the parent's income. The lock-in is 15 years and it can roll over for 5 years thereafter. If you have a girl, then you have another option available, Sukanya Samruddhi Investments. The policy is hold till the minors become major. These investments are debt investments and have a sovereign rating. Third is insurance. There are different plans available for investments on children plan segment. Parents and grandparents can also give the insurance to minor.
Oh, wow. And what about equity and mutual fund segments, which are doing so great?
See, in non-traditional investments, there are additional requirements depending on instruments. One, direct equity. PAN card on minor name is mandatory to open a demat account on minor name. Minor can open a demat account and can apply for IPO and have shares which can come as a gift from parents and from grandparents. Second, mutual fund. In mutual fund route, the minor can invest across mutual fund segments. Equity, debt, gold, or a hybrid, any segment. The investments are on minor name with guardian represent it. When a minor turns a major, by updating his status as major, child becomes individual holder in investment and guardian name gets removed. There are a children special plans too, which mutual fund offers for minors investment. These plans can be gifted from parents, relatives, etc. to the child. The investment does on the minor name with guardian and donor's details. Minor bank account details need to be registered in the investment. SIP also can be done in minor name with as low as ₹1,000 per month. This provides long-term investing with power of compounding benefits. This is the one of the best method to create the wealth or financial goal achievements.
Oh, okay. And Mitali, what about gold? Can minor invest?
See, gold normally sees as the hedge against the inflation. In electronic forms, gold can be purchased through gold bonds, through primary issue, normally announced by the RBI every month. These are auto-matured 8 years bonds, providing 2.5% yearly interest, which are payable half-yearly too. The capital gains arises on maturity is tax-free, so it will be better option for investor to invest in gold. Second is gold mutual fund. Investor can invest through lump sum as well as SIP route and can accumulate gold in the portfolio.
Mitali, can you give our listeners some of your example?
Yes, of course. See, I am the mother and as an advisor now for over a decade. The first thing I did was started an SIP in equity mutual fund with a 10% auto increase for a period of 18 years. And if you want to know some more details, visit us on www.gplcapital.com.
Thank you so much, Mitali. I hope this was an informative podcast to all our listeners. The topic for the next week podcast will be 3 large cap stocks to buy for long term. Hope to see you then. And don't forget to press the bell icon and subscribe on YouTube. Also follow us on Instagram, Twitter and Telegram for where we will try and make investing simple for you all. Thank you.